Hello friends, today we're going to be interacting with a smart contract through a UI, and we're going to do it through a very simple app that we're going to create in Flask. Flask is a very nice web framework that exists in the Python ecosystem. We are going to review first what is the structure of a Flask app, then the specifics of our dApp, and then how to get it connected with a smart contract. The smart contract that we are going to be working with is one that I deployed recently, which is my Guess the Number game. The structure of a Flask app is the following. You need to have a file that will load Flask. In this case, is my app.py. This one is just getting my Flask environment initialized and is setting the template that will be rendered in my root directory, which is the index.html template. We are going to talk about that one later. We have also this run.py, which is just an initializer that is kicking up this one. So that one is not very relevant. It just says that run the app. What is more important is the templates, right? So we have this index.html here that is interacting with my guess the number game contract. And what it's doing is allowing people to log in with MetaMask, of course, powered by Moralis, and it's allowing people to get the balance of a guess the number game according to the game ID. This is something that we are going to review a little bit later, what is the logic for doing that. You can see here at the top of the template that I have this extend declaration, and this is because I'm inheriting this base template HTML that I have here in this directory. And this base template is nothing more than a very simple skeleton of an HTML file that is loading Bootstrap for powering our UI to look a little bit better, a little bit nicer. So that's all for the server side. Now, once we move to the logic, since we are not serving any other view, and we are not kind of building our own APIs to wrap other APIs, this logic will be mostly be laid down in JavaScript. If you are working with the front end, you have to know your JavaScript a little bit. So don't get nervous about it. For this app, I will walk you through it. So what we're going to do in the JavaScript side is first you have to decide where you're going to store this JavaScript file. I like to have it in a directory that I call static, and inside that one in another directory that I call JS. That's just the structure that I prefer. And then the logic inside this one is very simple. I'm initializing my Moralis object here with credentials that I will get from Moralis. I have an ABI of a guess the number game contract, and the way I got it was that I went to the project that hosts the guess the number game, I went to build, I went to contracts, and then I have this JSON file here. This JSON file contains my ABI under this key over here. So I copied that, and this file has a lot more things, but I just copied the ABI and got it back to my file here, my JavaScript file. Then you need your contract address. With these two inputs, you are going to create a contract object. And this contract object is going to be created thanks to this Web3 object that we are getting by way of piggybacking with the Ethereum environment that MetaMask provides by itself. Something important to remember here is that there are ways to validate that MetaMask is installed and that you have a valid connection, but that goes above the scope of this project at this moment. Once we have this contract object, we are able to have a button to interact with one of the functions of the contract, which is get game balance. We provide what is the parameter that we need to send, which is the game ID. And for that, we are capturing it from the content of the HTML document. So we have an input field there for people to place the game ID number. Then we call it, and then we'll get the balance of that specific game ID. But we have an issue here, and the issue is that the call is asynchronous. So we're not going to get it right away. So we have another function here to get us the value in values of the specific token that we are working with. And since in the Ethereum network and compatible networks such as Matic and BSC, that's 18 decimals, so we're dividing it by 10 to the 18 to get the integer balance, not the decimals. And then we are populating that into another input field. We have our login function here that allows us to log in with MetaMask powered by Moralis, and we are allowing people only to log in once. So we are not going to allow them to play with the input files once they have already logged in, and we are not going to allow them to play with the game and contract interaction balances unless they are logging. So now we are going to get the data that we need to run this little app and interact with our smart contract. First of all, we are going to get our Moralis elements here. So we need our server URL and the application ID. For that, we just sign to Moralis. We have to have a server for this. And then we copy the application ID and we paste it in this part over here, and we copy our Moralis server URL, which is this one. Now we also need the contract. And remember that right now we're working in the Mumbai testnet of Polygon. So I have the contract that I want to interact with here, which is my guess the number game deployed to the Polygon Mumbai testnet. So I will copy the address. I take it to my Visual Studio Code. Then I save it. And now I can run my app. Remember, for that, you have to be in the virtual environment and in the directory of your Flask app. Having confirmed that you are, then you can just run Flask run. And this will kick off your development server, and this website should appear in your environment. Here we are. Another recommendation is that you go to MetaMask and verify that you are in Mumbai testnet. And this is very important because this is the network that we are going to be interacting. And for this to work, we have to be in the network. There are ways to programmatically check that we are in the right network on MetaMask, but this goes beyond the scope of this video. So let's do daniel@moralisweb3i.io. And this is not my email address, but let's log in with that one. Moralis is doing its magic. It's asking me to connect. I have to sign this transaction there, and here we are. Now I can interact with this part over here. And since in this server, actually, I already built some listener functionality, I can go to the dashboard and check what are the games I created before in this environment. So I will go here to created games Mumbai. And I see that I have three games that I have created before. And let's put the game number 0 here. And that one doesn't have any tokens inside. It was already depleted. Let's check game number 1. Same as same. Let's check game number 2. And in this one, we have some Matic token inside. And I was able to get what were the game's IDs of games previously created because I have this listener here that listened to that event on my contract. That's a topic for another video. So guys, remember that all the code for this project is available in the GitHub repository in the description of this video. And remember to like this video and subscribe to the Moralis channel. If you have any questions regarding how to use Moralis in the best way, join our Discord. If you have any question about this tutorial specifically, leave us a comment in the video and I will try to get there as soon as I can. So guys, thank you very much. This is Daniel. See you in the next video.